3, 2, 1.
We are fragile pieces of stardust, thrown together by fate, sent by the universe to drink the elixir of destiny. We're forged by hope, destroyed by pride. Continue to evolve in search of finding a better tomorrow.
Now you're getting into the creepy conspiracy realm.
Look, I'm going to stop you for a minute, and I'm going to correct you on something that I get tired of everybody saying.
Okay.
And that is, because it doesn't make sense to you right now, you just use the word conspiracy theory. And that is what happens a lot, especially in the news, that really ideas that because they're not in the mainstream, but they're out there and they're reputable ideas. I'll give you an example. Fucking UFOs.
I know.
Are you kidding me? They just admitted to this shit.
You know, 2021 is going to be even crazier, especially after the government has admitted to UFOs. You know, pretty soon they're just going to just jump off their ships and start strutting through the land, going, that's right, bitches. That's right, we were real,
nigga. That's right, we're real.
And we are here to do some probing of some anal cavity. Yeah, we're gonna take you all out now.
What is the big old hunk of cigar-shaped looking thing that passed by Earth a couple years ago?
They say a massive, fast-moving visitor to our solar system may have been a probe sent by an advanced alien civilization. Astronomers were excited to discover the interstellar object last year. It was named Oumuamua. That's Hawaiian for messenger or scout.
And a lot of scientists tried to say, oh, well, it can't be extraterrestrial. It's got to be this or it's got to be that. And just recently, there was a Harvard scientist that's saying, well, there's a big fat chance that it was a UFO.
Is it aliens? That's what two Harvard astrophysicists posed in a recent paper, suggesting that Oumuamua could be some type of alien spacecraft. And when we spoke with one of them, the idea didn't sound as far-fetched as you might think.
I prefer to adopt the maxim of Sherlock Holmes, that if you rule out the impossible, whatever remains, as improbable as it is, must be the truth.
Now, a good rule of thumb is that aliens are always the least likely answer. But here's the thing. The more reasonable explanation right now isn't panning out. Most astronomers think that Oumuamua is probably a stray comet from another stellar system. The only problem is that it doesn't look like any comet we've ever seen, because it appears to lack that iconic tail.
Keep in mind, we have never seen anything like that in the history. We don't even know if anything like that actually exists.
Right.
So that excuse is just as far-fetched as saying that it was extraterrestrial. But on the flip side, they don't even know if that type of comet exists, but they do know life forms exist in the universe because we exist.
Let's put things in perspective a little. There's an estimated 500 billion galaxies in one universe.
And each galaxy can have more or less than 100 billion stars.
And each star has a 50% chance that planets are orbiting around it. It's beyond mind-boggling. And this is why when people come up to me and they say that they are having some kind of personal relationship with some god.
But you don't understand, Gert. Out of all the billions of things in the universe, God has chosen me to have a personal love affair with. I know, I'm special.
People like this, you just can't even talk to anymore. Just look at them. Grab your keys and just go look at the shiny shit.
Assuming that there is a heaven, who would ever want to go there? Fucking boring!